got into a grassy area, and we're like, oh, this ain't good. And 2 minutes, 2 seconds later, we're running as fast as we can away from Cape Buffalo, charging at us. Oh. Which one's not to do?
Yeah. I've already had nightmares about this trip. I haven't had any stories like this.
Yeah. And it's pretty good because, you know, you'll see all these birds and be like, Morty, what's that? Morty, what's that? It's like, oh, that's a big bird. it's a bird.
It's a bird, Morty.
Second, maybe the third week of January. And we'll also put a pit tag. You guys familiar with pit tags?
Yep.
This gets the same thing that vets put in the dogs, and it has an individual ID number. These guys are obviously way too small to have an ear tag. So we just put a pit tag on their skin, and the following year, if you need, you can then scan it. We'll know which pub it is, and we'll put your tag in as a yearling. So the first thing we'll do is we'll find out if it's a yearling.
So you think she only had the one cub, or maybe one was lost?
No.
Or
they'll stay right in the den.
Thank you.
us an ID number.
I've used them in fish.
Yeah, you can use them in anything. You use them with fish,
people,
amphibians, reptiles, anything from larger mammals to the smaller stuff.
There you go. Now she has her individual ID number. Next year, we'll come back and we'll try and get this sow again and ear tag this one.
Hi. See the ferociousness? It's clawing at you guys. Remember that.
Really, their only instinct for me at this point is just to kind of hold on to anything. I'm not going to do it, but if I put her against myself, she would literally just stay there by herself. I could pull my hands away. She would just stay there and latch on.
So how many cubs have you guys counted this season so far?
I couldn't keep track.
Might be able to nab her.
Well, you want to get a picture of the cub?
Yep.
Right. Thank you.
Thank you.
I got it.
Adjacent.